Today on the Sonic Experience, without getting too technical, I'm going to cover some important things to know about phase. But if we want to understand phase, first we need to know a little about the physics of sound itself. I've defined sound in a way that's beneficial to the context at hand here. Sound is a wave of pressure cycling through states of compression and rarefaction. This is what causes our eardrums to move in and out. When recording sound, the diaphragm of a microphone replicates this action. The amount of compression and rarefaction determines the amplitude or decibel level of the sound. So the tighter these air molecules are pushed together and pulled apart, the louder the sound will be. The time it takes to complete one cycle of compression and rarefaction to pass by your eardrum, or in this case, a microphone diaphragm, determines its frequency or pitch. One complete cycle of a sound wave measures 360 degrees, 180 degrees of compression, and 180 degrees of rarefaction. When we talk about phase, we're referring to when exactly in time these peaks and valleys are occurring. But the phase of a sound is absolutely irrelevant until you introduce another sound from the same source and play them together. This is common when multi-miking drums, using a combination of DI and microphone for bass, or stereo miking guitar, and so on. If you were to nudge this sound wave forward or backward in time, or even flip the polarity of the phase 180 degrees, which is flipping it upside down, it doesn't even matter because it's by itself. But now let's add in another mic. Combining two waveforms either causes good constructive interference, which is when the summation of two signals causes a boost in amplitude, or bad destructive interference, when the summation of two signals causes the amplitude to be reduced. When you use more than one microphone to capture a sound, if one mic's further away than the other, it's the extra time it takes for the sound to travel to that mic that causes it to have a phase shift. This microphone is placed slightly further from the sound source, and as a result, the diaphragm is being pulled by rarefaction, while this other microphone's diaphragm is being pushed by compression. And since it's the same sound source, the waves are very similar and consist of the same frequencies. This is what causes phase cancellation or destructive interference. You wouldn't really get complete cancellation like these sine waves indicate, because these signals wouldn't be the exact same due to the microphone's slightly different position in space, and the mics aren't a matched pair, so they hear slightly differently. This just shows two sine waves that are exactly 180 degrees out of phase with each other. But you can have complete cancellation like this if you were to duplicate a track and invert the phase of one, or have digital signals that aren't in phase with each other, but in this situation, you would just end up with a weak signal after the two are summed together. It might look something like this one. Destructive interference can also occur because of a difference in polarity between two signals. Most common when top and bottom miking toms and snare drums, like in this illustration. When microphones are pointing in different directions at the same sound source like this, one mic may be receiving compression while the other rarefaction. Think about the way the drum head moves. The initial hit from the stick causes a downward motion on the skin, which compresses the air below, while rarefying the air above. Then the drum head swings back up and does the opposite to complete a full 360 degree wave. This will cause cancellation. One way to check this is to flip the phase of the bottom mic and see if the combined signals get louder. If so, the microphones were out of phase and you should leave the phase inverted on that bottom mic. I top and bottom mic the snare drum for an example. This is the bottom mic here. Listen to the difference when I invert the phase. I'll let it play through twice, before and after, so you can hear the difference. In this situation, I can really hear a big boost in volume, most noticeably in the low end. But you're not always exactly 180 degrees out of phase, so another way to fix issues like this is just to zoom way, way in on your file like this, all the way down to the sample level, to where you can actually see the waves and determine if the bottom microphone channel just needs to be nudged a hair left or right to be in phase with the top. In closing, I want to cover a few really interesting phase-related facts. The lowest frequency humans can hear is about 20 hertz or 20 cycles per second. A 20 hertz wave has a literal physical length of approximately a whopping 55 feet or 17 meters. That means over 27 feet of air is being compressed while the other 27 is being rarefied. Sound waves this low can't even properly develop in rooms smaller than this, but there's no musical information down that low anyway. At sea level, sound travels about 761 miles an hour, so even those long waves complete a cycle really fast, about 0.05 seconds. The highest frequency we can hear is about 20 kHz, or 20,000 cycles per second, and has a physical length of about 0.7 inches, or 1.8 centimeters, which completes a cycle extremely fast, a staggeringly quick 0.00005 seconds. So obviously we're working with very small increments in time when dealing with phase. Fractions of a millisecond can make a huge difference. Just some things to keep in mind. Alright everyone, hope that helps you understand phase and sound in general a little bit better. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.